Salamta, greetings and welcome to all within the human community. At this point in time, we would like to reason concerning the book of Revelations. Now, this video is intended to all Christ believers, to all that honestly, sincerely, and truthfully seek to walk in the way of Jesus Christ, Yehoshua, Yeshua, however it is that one recognizes the faithful fulfillment of the life and character of the Son of God. Now, this is intended to all those individuals, and we hope that ones are willing and able to receive this message. This is our way of stretching forth our arms in hopes of guiding and kind of directing true Christ believers into the truth contained within the book of Revelations. And you know, it might appear or it might seem that we are the least bit qualified to bring this message forth, and that's from a worldly perspective, and we completely understand. But you know, in the authority of Gita Jesus Christos, we are the most qualified to put this message forth, and we hope that ones can receive it. And we put this forth in hopes that this might be what ignites the fuse within inner enlightenment of our fellows, brothers and sisters within the Christian community, the human community. And so, you know, there is much speculation, basically there is way too much confusion as to the book of Revelations. First of all, let's begin with if ones are honestly seeking to follow in the way, seeking the righteousness of Gita Yesu, seeking to walk after Yahweh, in Yahweh, in the right way, more clearly, do away with all the negativity. First of all, scripture does not contain negativity, because our good creator is in fact that he is good, and so nothing that comes from our creator can be bad. And so I guess we begin by making mention that there's no negativity in scriptures. It is only an opportunity for I and I to grow in strength and in faith. And with that being said, let us address the issue of the Antichrist. You know, the book of Revelations is not to foretell the future. It's not for your curiosity. It's not to find exact dates. And most of all, most importantly, even though the ideas such as the Antichrist are presented in the book of Revelations, that is not the whole, that is the least important matter. I mean, this is the revelation of Gita Jesus Christos. It's not the revelation of the Antichrist or of Satan. So if ones honestly think themselves to be Christians, stop looking for evil. Stop looking for trouble. I mean, what is it that ones are trying to find? I mean, you're going to find yourself in a whole heap of misfortune if ones continue on that path and seeking the Antichrist and seeking the tribulations. And I mean, what are you so eager to receive? I mean, are the situations we are confronted with nowadays, are they not that bad that you seek even worse? I mean, things are pretty bad as it is. And so honestly, I mean, this is wisdom given to I and I as Rastafari by I and I Father, you know, to make our wills obedient to good influences is to show the greatest wisdom. And so we pass that on to all the Christian communities, whether, I mean, and this is not limited to a church or anything. We stress upon all that this is to all that are honest believers of Gita Jesus Christos. And so it's not limited to Christians, to Catholics, to Muslims, even to anything. I mean, this is to everyone that sincerely believes that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. And so with that being said, back to the whole Antichrist matter. You know, don't look for trouble. I mean, make your will obedient to good influences. We are looking for the right way. We're not looking for the wickedness. And you know, even beyond that, John t lets us know, and he tells us plainly and clearly that even in the days of Jesus Christus, the Antichrist was already present, and we confirm that even to this very day, his presence is amongst this world. We know who the prince of this world is, and so don't strengthen his presence upon this earth by you as so-called Christians or faithful in Christ, directing all of your focus and attention to the least important aspect of the book of Revelations. I mean, do away with that. These instructors, so-called preachers, pastors, whatever they call themselves, and they're only, I mean, either they're confused or they're doing this in a with wicked intent, but they're only confusing the multitudes and sending Christ believers into a totally opposite direction of instead of directing ones into the truth, the way and the life, to in time receive life more abundantly. But no, instead ones are directed into the end of the world, into the Antichrist, into foolish ideas that are going to, have been coming to pass, are coming to pass, and will come to pass. And so, but it's not for us to get stuck in that. It's nonsense. I mean, just think about it. Are you following Christ or are you following the devil, Satan? So do away with all that negativity. The righteous way, the way of Jesus Christus, seeking after his righteousness is a positive movement. It's a and so let's keep it at that. With that being said, now this next little segment, I guess we could call it, is more intended to the Rastafari. We mentioned earlier that we are the most qualified to put this message out because we as Rastafari have been given all the secrets. We are the initiates. We are the initiated into all the mysteries. We are the mystery school. We know it all the secrets. We follow him, and we've been given to receive by the Father of him that we follow all the secrets. I mean, it's like when Peter said, "Who else are we gonna?" I mean, you have it all the secrets. You have it all the secrets to the kingdom. I mean, why are we gonna stop from following Christ and go another way? I mean, you it is that has all the secrets. And so, with that being said, us Rastafari have been given all the secrets. We know we are the mystery schools. I mean, all these Illuminati, Masons, and all these different groups. I mean, they could have all the money, all the influence, all the power that they think that they have, but they don't have the truth. And the most, I mean, I guess, no, we don't guess, we know. It's the most important truth. We know who God is, and we know, and we seek to even go further and know what it is that we are to do, and to us it's been given the answers to most of these questions that many have died for, that many have lived all their lives trying to attain, that many lives have been sacrificed to attain these answers. And so, we are the ones that are to preach to the world the good news, and the good news is that God the Father has manifested in the flesh, in His Imperial Majesty, Kedamawi Haile Selassie, King of Kings, Elect of God, Conquering Lion of the Tribe of Judah, Emperor of Ethiopia. And so, that is the greatest mystery. I mean, God, the living God, we know it, who the living God is, and so it is up to us to enlighten the rest of the world with the truth, and because back to the non-Rastafari, because most of us are confused. I mean, we're directed into so many different ways, but none of these are the right way. None of these lead to Yahweh. And so let us go into what the book of Revelation is. I guess it's the revelation. It's pretty clear. It's the vision, the revealing, the coming down of the curtains, the removal of the veil. It's Christ revealed, and in these latter days, it's His Imperial Majesty, Kedamawi Haile Selassie, Emperor of Ethiopia, King of Kings, Elect of God, Conquering Lion of the Tribe of Judah. It's that simple. That should be, I guess, what I would assume that in the hearts of faithful Christians, so-called, it would be your highest interest to become knowledgeable in who has been revealed as the living God, and in this case, God the Father, you know? But many seem to do otherwise, and we take our responsibility in that as Rastafari, because maybe we haven't been putting out the message all that clear, and so this is the attempt. We stretch forth our arms to all those that have not received the full truth, and we hand it to you. This is the truth, you know? Most importantly, not only is it the revelation of Gita Jesus Christus, it's the revelation of the hearts of the individuals. This is going to test your heart. Will you honestly seek after the truth, or will you continue kind of looking at this as a kind of fairy tale, something that you think you believe, but you don't look into and you don't look for? It's like, what do you think? I mean, that Jesus and himself is going to knock at your door and bear witness in front of your eyes. It's honestly, who do you think you are, you know? So it is our duty to seek after him, you know? He's leading the way. We are to follow him, Geta Jesus, and in doing so, you'll come to the overstanding. But back to the revelation of the heart, you know? Will you accept the fact of the matter, or will you reveal your anger, your hatred, your racism, your inability to love your neighbor as thyself, you know, which is the greatest commandment? Well, the greatest commandment is to love God Almighty, with all our hearts, mind, and might, right? But then it's to love our neighbors as ourselves. Will you reject the neighbor because he might speak a different language, because he might look a little different, because the shade of his skin pigmentation might be somewhat different than yours? Are you going to allow the nature, the flesh nature, the physical nature of Yeta Jesus Christos, and the fact that he is Ethiopian? Are you going to allow that to be an obstacle, and are do you rather spend an eternity suffering, you know, just on the basis of discrimination? I mean, just think about it. I mean, this is the revelation of not only our Lord and Savior, Black Lord and Savior, Jesus Christus. It's gonna tell what kind of heart do you got, you know? And we say that sincerely. We would hope that everyone would kind of just like do away with all the discrimination and look into His Imperial Majesty as Him being who He be, because there's no one else, and He is the faithful fulfillment. His life and character fully fills every bit of word, every word jotted down has been fulfilled by His Majesty, at least that which is supposed to be fulfilled up to this present time, because more will continue to be fulfilling. But as far as his role in this motion picture, he has made his visitation. He has done that which it has been expected of him, and this is referring to scripture. And he played the part, he played the role, he fulfilled the life and character, and that's to say that more is to be revealed, right? But look into it. I mean, try His Imperial Majesty. Don't take our word for it. We challenge ones to look into it. I mean, we dare ones to look into it. I mean, we assure that His Imperial Majesty will not let ones down. We may not know everything, but one thing we can assure without any reasonable doubt, without any doubt whatsoever, as a matter of fact, the truth of His Majesty, His glory just makes it erases the word doubt. There is no doubt. Doubt is no longer existent upon this earth because the glory of His Majesty shine it so bright that doubt is it's lost. It never existed. It's been, you know, it's been blown away like chaff. And so basically, getting back to the matter, try him, you know, look into it, do away with discrimination, Yes, so even in the book of Revelation, he says, and it's chapter, hold on one second. We're gonna go to that. Chapter 3 it is, and it's well, let's start from verse 14. And to the angel of the church of the Laodiceans write, these things said the Amen, the hidden one. To Rastafari, it has been revealed who the hidden one is, but it's not limited to I and I. This is the grace of the Almighty is abundant. It is awesome. And so, do your best to take part in this. I mean, it is your right as a individual, as a human, as a member of the human community. And so we extend this message out to ones that are willing to receive. Continuing, these things said the Amen, the faithful and true witness, the beginning of the creation of God. I know thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. I would thou wert cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth. Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable, the poor and poor and blind and naked. I counsel, this is a verse that we apologize for the terrible reading. in a worldly sense, we're not qualified, but in Christ, yes, I mean, we're more than qualified. So basically, let us get to the qualification. It's we were actually seeking after verse 18, where it reads, I counsel thee to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou mayest be rich. Have you tried your have you tried if you have a good heart? And I would, this is genius. I mean, the fact of the true humanity of His Majesty and His Christ, is brilliant, because what better stumbling block could be? Well, it's a potential stumbling block, but what else in these times, in these so discriminating and racist times, what else could try your heart with fire and see if it's gold, that is worthy, that will withstand that judgment. And so, just think about it. And we say this because we notice that many instructors and stuff like that, we get the sense that they honestly are believers in Christ, but they have no idea of the truth. It's been concealed, so it's been so well concealed from the mass multitudes, and so from the majority of the world. And so we understand how ones could not really know, and so that is what we're attempting here. We stretch forth our arms and hand over the truth, receive it if ones are willing. It, like we said, we take on the responsibility of not being, not doing diligence in putting out this message, but this is our attempts to do so, to correct that which was once a mistake. And we refer to Rastafari not putting out the message, so we put it out again. God the Father manifested in the flesh, the Word becoming flesh once more, as did in the as it has been done in the days before in Jesus Christus. Now the Father has been revealed in the life and character of His Imperial Majesty, Kedamawi Kaila Shilasi, King of Kings, Elect of God, Conquering Lion of the Tribe of Judah, Emperor of Ethiopia. No way around it. It is the only truth, and so receive it open-heartedly. It's good news. It's great news. Will you take a part in the Book of Life, or will you be blotted out? It comes down to that. Now forward to Rastafari. Yeah, everything is important in the book of Revelations, but one of the things that has been revealed to I and I is that it's kind of like, for us that know what the secrets, it's not about focusing on tribulations and stuff. We accept it to be more of a clear message. Patience is the kingdom of the saints. We know its secrets. Now we are to prove our faithfulness, and we are to be patient, and patience worketh the faith, and so we are to be faithful till the very last day, to the completion of our pilgrimage here upon earth. We are to live faithfully each one of those days that has been ordained or prescribed or numbered to us, you know. And Jawulin, we as Rastafari, we hope that everyone, we would hope that everyone, that may not be the case, but it doesn't have to not be the case, you know. And so we hope we all make it, and just, this is the message in the book of Revelations. To overcome is to be patient for us that know the secrets, and we still have to work on on everything, right? It's not it's our God is a God of holiness, and so we just choose to focus on patience. It's not saying that we have perfected every other aspect in life itself, but focusing on Book of Revelations and the message of patience. Be patient, you know, overcome this. And on the other hand, it also teaches us, kind of like it gives us a direction as far as what we got to work on. For it, like that verse that we read, and we didn't do such a great job. It's referring to, you know, we get to Jesus, it's like, I rather you be cold or hot, you know, don't be in between. And so if we happen to have that problem, then we work on it. And it gives us, the book of Revelations, it's really neat in the sense that it gives us a lot of kind of like direct hints, you know. After it says something really important that is worthy, not only worthy, that is necessary for ones to correct in their walk towards Getayesus, it always states that which needs to be worked on, needs to be fixed. And then it says, you know, them that have ears, let them hear. It's like it's pointing out like the importance of what has been spoken or written prior to that. It's kind of like a hint, you know, like father calling to son, you know. If you have ears to hear, you know, kind of expressing the importance of that which has been spoken prior to this hint. And so with that, we continue by saying that last note, a lot, you know, people and honestly, it's not limited to, but I guess this message in a way is kind of like towards the Gentiles, because you know, unfortunately you've been deceived, like probably you're just the deception that most of Gentiles have received has been far superior than most other deceptions, in the sense that, you know, your instructors, honestly, they're not, some don't know, but some aren't telling you, and so, you know, they're not with you, honestly. I mean, and this is not to bring up like separation, because we're all members of the human community, but we just would like to point out that, you know, for white people, and we have just as much love for you than any other people, but which is why we're pointing this out. Your instructors do not have your best interest in mind, you know, because a lot of these people are knowledgeable in the truth, and they're not telling you, and they won't tell you. I've noticed when they come across, it's not all of them, right? Some are ignorant. Some honestly just have not been confronted or even presented with the idea, much less the truth of who is the living God. And so that is our fault, and so we take responsibility for that. But some of your instructors, we notice this, they come across scripture as Revelation, Book of Revelation chapter 1 verses 13, and then we see a change in face expression and facial expression. We see kind of like a looking around, a kind of like a change in posture, and we notice that it's like that dilemma: are we going to speak the truth and that which is in our hearts, and we know it, you know, even if they don't know exactly who His Majesty is, they know that there's something that they have to say say about that scripture, but they hold back and they continue on forward. And so we notice these kind of reactions, and that's a clear indication of like, okay, I'm confronted with something controversial. Do I speak the truth? Do I speak my heart and say, you know what, this kind of is inferring this, or whatever knowledge it is that the individual possesses? That moment is critical. It's a time in judgment when one shows himself approved, or one fails to be faithful and receive the truth for what it is in spirit and in truth. And so, for instance, many will just skip over these verses, but many will address tiny details, knowing very well that there is much more to reveal. And so chapter 1 verse 13 of the book of Revelation reads, "And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like to the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the foot, and girt about the paps with a golden girdle." The foot and girt about, verse 14, "His head and his hairs were white as wool," white like wool, "as white as snow." And so this is where the demons creep in, and the wicked them try to twist things and kind of, use these little flaws in the King James translation to implant erroneous or wrong ideas into the minds of individuals, to implant evil thoughts. And so we as Rastafari will not even allow for any breathing space to the wicked. And so we will do away with we already see what ones would come up with, ones trying to deny the truth. "His head and his hairs were white like wool." They're going to say that in this case the color white it's being presented as it's using wool. They're gonna say, the wicked them are gonna try to twist this in the sense that they're using wool to white wool to describe the color. So wicked them, if we allow for them to breathe, they'll breathe all over us. And so they'll say that, oh, this isn't saying that his hair is woolly. This is saying that they're trying to say that his hair was white, and that they're using white wool as a reference point to make that, to establish that truth. And so that is not the case, because it goes on to make mention as white as snow. And so the first description is obviously not describing the color white, and there's probably some technicalities and some there's probably a lot more in that verse if one's reference the words to the original words that were translated. And so Blue Letter Bible Dictionary online is a good source, but anyways. And so it goes on to mention white as snow, and therefore the first reference is indicating a woolly hair, and the second reference is describing the color of the hair. And so if we continue, "And his eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet like to fine brass, as if they burned in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters. And he had in his right hand seven stars, and out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword, and his countenance was as the sun shineth in his strength." And so, first note, the sun shining in his strength. In this case, it says the sun, S-U-N. We're going to assume that is the actual word that was translated meaning sun. And but still, not only is it describing his feet like fine brass in the furnace, it's describing the color of the skin of an Ethiopian in true humanity, as so is the Son and the Father. But also the sun shining in his countenance, it's dark-skinned black-skinned individuals, although not necessarily black, the color black, the cap, very dark brown, or in the case of His Majesty, you do have a sense of the sun shining in his countenance, getting that golden brass or brass kind of reflection from his countenance, from his face, so it's not only is it describing his glory, but because, wicked them would want to make a painting and just put like a bright, not put details in the face, you know, and just put like a bright light. That's not the case, you know. It's in this case, it's giving us a similarity of the sun shining off of an Ethiopian's face and how it shines in let's go back to that. We kind of the countenance, and his countenance was as the sun shineth in his strength. The countenance is his expression, his facial expression, as the sun shining in his face. Just look a picture of his majesty, and it's like his feet, like fine brass burnt in the fire. You know, really glary, really shiny, really and you only get that with like the dark brown colored skins, you know, pigmentation on the skin. And so continuing, last note, you know how we mentioned that the Book of Revelation gives us like kind of like pointers, hint, you know, this is important. Those who have ears, let them hear, you know. If you have eyes to see, and even like here is wisdom, you know, check this out. This is really important, you know, take note of this. Here is wisdom. It's also his majesty and his walk and his way. It's funny because in coming out of Ethiopia and the Italian invasion, that whole dragon being healed and then once wounded, now healed, the Vatican, Italy and Rome, the alliance, and you know, on their way to whatever, establishing their so-called kingdom, nonsense. Anyways, His Majesty coming out of Ethiopia in exile, well, not exile, just fully filling scripture. I believe this interview or this speech, more correctly, is taking place in Jerusalem before heading out to Bath. But before the speech, they're introducing him, and his Imperial Majesty starts, you know, like he's really into it, but he's getting his mustache ready, you know, for the speech. And we know that the Almighty Creator, that is good, even in his manifestation as man, has a sense of humor, right? And it's, you know, don't take this the wrong way, but it's really like him, you know, to do stuff like that other individuals would never even assume it to be so. But he's sharpening up those swords, you know, and if ones are wise, you know, he's not gonna tell you anything. He doesn't owe you anything to be telling you. It's to be telling you straight out what his role and purpose. That's up to you to figure out. You know that it's your job, the reader of scripture, to figure out these things. Is it? I mean, the grace, the mercy shown by him is more than enough, you know. And so don't expect them to tell you, but at times we see it as kind of comical how he's sharpening up those swords, you know. Those that have eyes to see, let them see. Those that have ears to hear, let them hear. Here is wisdom, you know. Like check this out, you know, a sharp two-edged sword coming from his mouth, you know. And so got to make sure they're really sharp. And so he does a lot of stuff like that you have to pay close attention. And it helps because when we read this scripture, when we began to study, the first thing that came to mind, oh, that's His Majesty, you know. Like we remembered that exact I guess like that footage. And so it's really great, you know. If we look into it, the more we look into it, we realize that His Majesty is so kind and so generous. Not only did he spend his life, his pilgrimage serving the people of Ethiopia, serving the world, but he reveals much more than we could have ever imagined, you know, and much more continues to be revealed to all those willing to seek it out, you know. So patience, I mean, we're concluding here. Patience to the Rastafari. Patience is the kingdom of the saints. Seek out the truth to non-Rastafaris. Look, you know, try every spirit. Him that testifieth that the Son of God came in the flesh is of God. And you know, the revelation, look for the revelation of Jesus Christus, not Satan, not the Antichrist, not the end of the world, not 2012, not December something, 2012. It's revelation. Look for Christ revealed in these latter days. And Last note, the revelation of one's heart, you know, set all discrimination aside and join, you know, the movement, the positive movement. It's eternal, it's everlasting, it's life more abundantly. I mean, what else could one ask for? And repentance is the key, it's a must. And you know, if the repentance is pure and truthful and you know, no faking it, the Father knoweth all, then thou shalt be accepted, you know. We got nothing else to say. You know, God the Father, the living God, is His Imperial Majesty, Kedamawi Kaile Shilasi, elect of God, King of Kings, conquering line of the tribe of Judah, Emperor of Ethiopia. You can't miss it, you know. Look for it. We give thanks to all. Shalom, Rastafari.